Katrina.
Anna.
I've been trying to reach you. Where were you?
And Gael? How's he doing?
Oh, well, he still couldn't accept the truth.
Okay, I'll go and talk
Katrina, just hold on. I think that it's best that we give him space for now. You were together last night, right? What happened then?
Are you blaming me, Anna? If you want to say something, then say it to my face right now.
No, I just want to know what happened, okay? Why did Gael do that? What did you tell him? And did you try to stop him?
Let's get one thing clear, Anna. Just because you saved my life before doesn't mean you can talk to me like that right now. Do you understand me? Yes, you may be his girlfriend now. But before that, it was I who was married to him. And before that, we were childhood friends and best friends as well. I know Gael very well. Unlike you, who just suddenly walked into his life and acted as if you knew him. So don't ever tell me what's best for him, Anna, okay?
And you think what's happening now is best for him?
So what? Are you really blaming me? Huh?
Let's not make everything worse.
Sorry? Anna, you just made it worse. You should have stayed away from me. Because I don't really need a sister. Especially someone like you.
Gael, do you think that? I didn't feel bad whenever I saw the two of you together. I know you're longing for a father's love. But I couldn't tell you the truth. That he was your father because he couldn't acknowledge you anyway. Gael, I never wanted to hurt you. I would rather be the one hurting than to see you suffering like this.
But you chose to stay by his side no matter what. You always chose him, Mom.
I chose to complete our family, Gael. My son, please give us another chance. I know that you know very well that we love you so much.
Leave me alone.
Ready to give you a chance. Because I thought we could fix the things between us, but I guess I was wrong. Because you didn't change at all, Anna.
Wait, what do you mean?
You took Gael away from me, Anna. Clearly you never change at all, because ever since we were kids, you've been taking everything away from me. Because you're selfish, because you're greedy.
That's not true, okay?
Anna? Sam, what's going on here? What?
Anna, are you okay?
Of all places, you guys had to argue here?
Sam?
Mom, I really didn't want this to happen. I didn't want Gael to be imprisoned, okay? All I wanted was to help.
Okay, Sam. I think that we should go home. Let's go. Let's give Gael a chance to process everything. If you really want to help him, give him some space. Let's go, Sam. Anna?
You go ahead, I'll follow you.
Thank you.
Have you talked to Gael? How is he doing now?
What do you think?
This is all your fault! You should have acknowledged him right from the start! I wanted to tell him the truth so bad, but you told me it would only confuse Gael. Look what you did to your own son. Look what's happening to him right now.
Do you think this is easy for me? You think I wanted this to happen? This was not part of the plan. I wanted to wait until I become president and Gael succeeds as a politician before I tell him the truth. That he's my son!
Salvador, that's never going to happen because Gael already hates the both of us.
I will do everything I can not to lose him.
In that case, drop the charges you filed against Gael. I'm serious, Salvador. Your actions are only making him more upset. Do you want to gain Gael's trust back? Then do it the right way. Be the father that he needs. Don't treat him like this.
Sam, you're not coming inside?
No, Mom, it's okay. I just want to be alone.
Do you want me to join you?
No. I just want to think.
Samantha, I know you well. Talking to me will really make you feel better.
I did everything to have a complete family, Mom. But why this? I really did everything I can to be a good wife to Gael and a good mother to Ellie. But why did this happen? Both of them have left me alone. And even the remains of Ellie, I don't have them now.
Samantha, listen to me. You didn't lose everything. I'm still here. So don't you ever feel like you were on your own, okay? Because we are still here. Your family who love you so much. Come here.
Where is she?
Samantha's not here. She left already.
Where'd she go?
She didn't tell me. I tried contacting her, but she is not replying. Anna, I know what Samantha told you last night was really hurtful. But please, don't lose faith. Samantha doesn't trust people easily. And I really hope that you don't give up on her.
Don't worry, Hillary. She's still family. I won't give up on her. Don't worry. I believe we'll be able to make up. Salvador needs to pay for what he did to my sister and Gael.
We'd be able to do that if only we can find a witness who will testify against Salvador. The video isn't enough evidence in our case against him.
But where will we find a witness?
Mrs. Noble and I already talked. We have a lead.
I'll go to the hospital.
Xander. Hospital? What hospital?
The hospital where former President Noble died. Mrs. Noble gave us a list of the hospital staff who were there when the president died.
But President Noble has been dead for 20 years.
Anna, I know it's a long shot, but there's no harm in trying, remember?
Well, no. If we really need a witness, Katrina will do. She was there when Salvador had me killed. She can testify against Salvador.
But then will Samantha help you?
I'm not so sure.
I'll talk to her, Anna. I will try to convince her. I know both of you still don't see eye to eye, but this time, you both want the same thing, and that's to take Salvador down.
I hope so.
I'll do everything for us to be complete again, Ellie. Gael will come back to us. I promise you that.
Oh, you better let me in!
Em, you can't go in there!
Don't you dare try to stop me, because I'll do whatever I want, understand?
Just leave us.
Okay.
Ellie!
Hey, wait!
Mom! Give
wait,
me my daughter!
Wait. Samantha, she's my granddaughter. I have the right to be with her.
Well, you lost whatever right you had to my daughter the day you killed her, Mom Miranda. You give me Ellie!
We had nothing to do with what happened to Ellie.
Oh, is that right? Really? And where do you find the nerve to say to my face that you had nothing to do with my daughter's death, huh? I just want to be with my daughter! And you know very well how hard it is to be a mother. And you will do anything in this world for your child's happiness. You'll give everything in a heartbeat, even your very own life, for your child's safety. But you have no idea how hard and painful it is to lose your very own child. You have taken her future with me away from her. So please listen. I'm begging you. Don't keep my daughter away from me even at this point, Mom.
Just keep your distance from Salvador. We'll do everything we can to have the charges dismissed, Gael.
Thank you, attorney. What are you doing here?
I'm here to withdraw the charges against you.
And how can we be sure about that?
Ask the fiscal officers.
Can I talk to you just for a moment in private? Just for a while?
I'm sorry, I won't let you talk to my client without my presence.
I'll handle it myself, attorney. Diego, come on.
Gael, I admit I was hurt by what you did. I got carried away. I didn't think a son could do that to his own father. And I could never do that to you. Because you're my son.
Do you want to make it up to me? Then do the right thing already. We're in a police station right now, so you can confess all your crimes.
If you're talking about Anna's accusations, I had nothing to do with any of those.
And what do you care?
Sam, how did you do that?
I took care of it. Mom Miranda had no choice but to give me back my daughter's remains.
You went there by yourself?
Yes.
You're aware how dangerous it is for you to go there. Don't make rash decisions from now on, I'm telling you, Samantha. What if something bad happened to you there?
Mom, relax. Nothing bad happened, okay? Besides, Ellie's here now.
That is not the point, Samantha. Promise me that this will be the last time that you'll do something like this without telling us. Promise me.
Hillary's right, Katrina. I would have accompanied you there if you had told me.
Well, I was not aware that I still needed to get permission from you to get my daughter back.
Miranda.
Samantha came here uninvited. She took Ellie's urn.
How did she do it?
How was your talk with Gael?
He's still furious.
Because I told you not to send your own son to jail. You just gave him a reason to loathe you even more.
I withdrew the charges. Miranda, I need you. I need you so we can become a family. I need you beside me to salvage our own family.
We can fix this, Salvador. But please, be more mindful of your actions.
That she's with you now.
She's my daughter. Nothing could have stopped me from getting her remains back from the filthy hands of the criminals who took her life. And I won't stop until I get justice for the death of my daughter.
Listen, it's all in your hands now.
What do you mean?
Testify against Salvador. Fight back. And then give your testimony.
No. Anna, I don't have plans of making my testimony against Dad.
Listen, I know you were there the night he had me killed. And I know you're part of his syndicate. Let's use that against him.
And? If I talk, what good would that do to us? Anna, you know what Dad is capable of doing, and you're even aware of what he did to your allies. What if he does the same to me?
Of course I'll never let that happen to you.
And what makes you so sure? Anna, it's obvious. You can't take Dad down.
I didn't want to drag you into this. But whatever you know, that's the only way we can finally take Salvador down.
Doing here?
May I enter? Gael, I know you're angry with me because we chose to hide the truth. I hope I had changed your mind.
You can't change anything.
Look what I got. We had so many stuff. Many pictures of us together when you were much younger. Look. Look at this. Look at that.
I never acknowledged you. But I stood as your father figure since then. I made sure that I was there always by your side while you were growing up.
Just give Samantha more time to decide. Eventually, she'll understand why she has to do it.
I understand, and I don't want to force her into it.
You know what? I don't expect her to change at all. I'm so sorry, Hillary. But ever since we met her, Samantha has only shown us how selfish she is to other people. Even after finding out that Anna's her sister. I think we shouldn't expect her to change.
Sander, Samantha is in a tough situation as well. Of course she fears for her life, especially now.
Maybe we can think of another plan.
Fine, but now we only have a list of hospital staff during that time. I'll talk to each one of them. We might uncover something that the cops could have missed then.
Okay, that'll be great. Thanks, Sander.
This I ask of you. Don't you ever, ever give up on Samantha. I know eventually she will do the right thing.
Gael, I was afraid. I was afraid of what people might think of me. I was afraid all of my hard work would go to waste, which was for all of us in the first place. But I regret that now. I regret everything, and it's upsetting that even though I was with you, you were still very sad because your father wasn't by your side. But now you know the truth. I will always be by your side. Even if you keep pushing me away. I will wait for you. I'll wait. Until there's no more anger in your heart. You are a Del Mundo, Gael. And that will never change. You're my son. So I will wait for you. I'm a call away. No questions asked. I just want us to reconcile.
Samantha, you know that if you need me, I'm always here. But sweetie, your sister needs you right now.
Mom.
Look, if this is again about testifying against Dad, my goodness, I cannot believe that Anna just used
me. No! Anna is not using me. Because I believe it's the right thing to do. You always say that you've finally turned your back on Salvador. But if you're allowing him to get away with every evil thing that he did, it's no different from being bound to him. Samantha, just think of your family. Think of Anna. They're all counting on you right now to fight for the justice they need.
But Mom, I'm scared.
Dad will send me to jail. No, please. Mom, please, I don't want that. Please, do not force me.
Okay. Okay, dear. What did he want?
Reconciliation.
Gael, if only I could ease your worries now, I would. You know I would. Just always remember that I'm here for you. I'm always by your side.
I know that.
and I'm sorry.
Why say sorry?
Anna, because you don't deserve this life. You deserve to be happy. To be away from your troubles and problems. You need peace. I know that since I came into your life, I've caused you nothing but suffering.
Gael, don't say that. I'm happy. I can endure this. As long as I'm with you.
But I know that it's really hard for you, Anna. And even if you're not saying it, I know that I'm one of the reasons why you and Samantha are still at odds right now.
Don't worry about that, Gael. Katrina and I have our differences. But I know that the day will come when she'll finally see how much I love her. And I won't ever give up on her. I won't stop until we're okay. But right now I'm certain of one thing. Nothing can tear us apart. We'll survive any storm in the way. Nothing will ever change how I feel about you.
Some of these people are already dead, while the others have gone abroad, so I can only give you their addresses, sir.
Okay, thank you. Mr. Ponso, you were on duty when President Noble died in this hospital, weren't you?
Yes, I was on duty that day.
So did you notice anything strange?
I didn't notice anything that strange that day. But...
But what?
That time when President Noble died, one of his nurses suddenly just resigned. I found it strange, because she badly needed money, but she didn't get into a new job. She practically had no reason to leave.
Do you remember the name of that nurse?
It's Nika Rivera. Yes, Nika Rivera, sir.
Nika Rivera.
Yes, you might find her address in there.
Nika Rivera. Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome.
This information is definitely helpful. Thank you so much, Mr. Ponso.
You're always welcome, sir.
Please, accept this as my way of saying thank you.
Oh, wow. Thank you so much, sir.
All right. Take care, sir.
Oh, well, excuse me.
We should start looking for the nurse as soon as possible.
Xander managed to get that nurse's last address.
Then I'll go find her myself.
Anna, I'll come with you.
No, if she knows something and we look for her in groups, I'm sure Salvador will find out about it. It's better if I do this alone.
Anna, you will need all the help that you can get, so you should just let Xander go with you, all right?
No, we still need to talk to someone, that Montemayor. Xander, you should just do that instead. The more people we convince, the easier it'll be for us to take down Salvador.
Just be careful, Anna.
Thank you.
Be careful about what?
I think we should just keep this from you. It's too dangerous.
Oh, really? So, you guys don't want to tell me, huh? Just because I don't want to do what you asked me to do.
You got the wrong idea. Please don't take it against us, Katrina. Okay then, I should go.
Mom! I'm sorry, Sam. I don't know much about it either.
What did Gael say?
Oh, well.
he still won't acknowledge me.
Like father, like son.
It might take a while before he can accept it. But I can still wait. This will be over soon.
Salvador. Gael grew up his whole life without a father. And he will continue to live his life even without you. Especially since Anna is by his side.
We've tried to get rid of her several times already, Miranda. So, have you come up with a better plan then, huh?
We should plan everything carefully this time. Or else we might suffer the consequences.
And the only thing I want is to complete my plans. And to clean up that mess that Anna has caused our family. And to unite the three of us. You, Gael, by my side.
So do I, Salvador. I wish we can start over. As if we've just woken up from a nightmare.
As long as we're together, we can get through anything.
Yvonne?
What?
What is it about the nurse Mom mentioned earlier? What's Anna's plan right now?
Sam, Anna talked to me about it. She might get mad if I tell you the details.
But why? Are you scared of her?
No, not really. I just don't want any trouble.
Well, just tell me. No one will find out anyway. Because they all think that I'm selfish. But what I honestly want is to not feel that I'm useless here. So if there's a way for me to help without risking my safety, why wouldn't I do it, right?
All right, fine. It's about the nurse that disappeared after President Noble's death. Anna's now looking for her.
So that Anna wants to play the hero in all of this again. Well, if she thinks I'll just sit here and do nothing, she's sorely mistaken. Give me the address of that nurse.
Are you sure about that?
Yes, I'm very sure. Give it to me now.
If you want to take down Salvador, it's your call. But I know him well. He's not going down without a fight.
You'll never know you have a fighting chance if you're consumed with fear. I don't believe that we cannot take him down at all. Only you have the power to be able to do that.
My family and I are leaving. They're my priority, and not this battle that you're waging against Salvador.
So you'll just run away? That's your solution? Why are you even the president? Huh? You're such a coward.
Call me that all you want, but there's nothing I can do. I'm involved in this mess caused by Salvador, so I will save myself this time. I advise you to do the same. What you're doing is madness.
Mr. President, you need to trust in what we can do and have faith in us.
I've known Salvador from way back. He's evil to the core. He'll do anything to make sure he wins.
But now things are about to change. We have someone who's willing to testify against him.
Who is it?
What's the point in telling you who that is? You're too afraid to fight.
Gael.
Hi, Aunt. Can we talk right now?
About what?
Tell me, are you also mad at me?
Gael, we were only deceived, and the truth was hidden from us. It's Salvador who's at fault, and not you. You're a victim, too, since the time you and Samantha became best friends. I've regarded you as a son already. At least it all makes sense now, the way Salvador's always been attached to you.
especially when our child died. Honestly, I think Salvador loved you more than he did Samantha.
I'm sorry if I've caused you so much pain. And to Samantha, too.
I'm not angry. And it's not your fault. There's nothing to be sorry for.
Thank you, Aunt. What is that?
I'm just looking at the properties that I have left. Samantha's having problems with her business.
What kind of problems?
Just some problems with the bank. She made late payments and she also has some loans that are still unpaid.
Okay, Aunt. I'll go to the bank and look at the terms of her loan. I'll see what I can do about it.
No need, Gael. Don't trouble yourself about it. I know that you and Anna have important things to do. If only I had access to my money, I would have solved this.
Wait, so how's the case involving my mom?
They haven't found the money that Miranda and Salvador stole from me. The lawyer said that it's going to take some time. Actually, if I were only to choose, I'd like a very simple life. But I know that money will be a big help for Anna and Samantha.
All right, Aunt. I'll see what I can do to have that money be returned to you.
Gael, you don't have to do that, all right?
Listen, I want to help you. Let me make up for everything.
If that's so, thank you.
Hello? We need to talk now.
All right.
Ma'am? Excuse me, can I ask you something?
What is it, dear?
It's just that somebody gave me this address. Does Nika Rivera live here?
Wait, aren't you Ana de Masalang? You're the woman who's going against Senator Del Mundo. I've been seeing you on the news every day.
Yes, that's me.
Why are you looking for Nika?
I just want to ask her something regarding President Noble.
I don't know where Nika is right now.
Ma'am, I really need your help.
I don't want to get involved with this.
Ma'am, involved? You don't need to be scared about it. I just want to talk to her. I'm not doing this just for me, but for Senator Del Mundo's victims as well.
Okay.
Really, ma'am? So is Nika inside the house?
No, she's not here.
Is that so?
And where is that woman?
Katrina, what are you doing here?
The same reason you're here. So where is Nika Rivera? Bring her here. I want to talk to her.
Just a moment. Aren't you Samantha Del Mundo, Senator Del Mundo's daughter?
Yes. You're right. So, bring that nurse to us now. I want to talk to her.
I can't help you with that. Please leave now.
Wait, ma'am, please listen to me. I just want to ask her something. Please.
Just go away.
Ma'am, what?
I said leave.
Ma'am. What are you doing here? How did you find this place?
Did you really think that you could hide this from me, Anna? We're both seeking justice here. And I already told you that if you're finding a way to take Dad down, I will help you.
Yes, but you shouldn't have interfered a while ago. She was going to tell me something.
So what? It's my fault again?
Well, no. Please, just go home.
No! I'm not going home, Anna. I should know whatever you know, too. Either we argue here or we look for that nurse together.
No, we don't have to argue. All right. Let's work together.
Good. Let's go.
Let's start there.
Grandma? I have to go, so just please tell Anna that I came by.
All right, Gael.
Grandma? I know that you're seeing me differently now since the truth came out. But I want to apologize for every single thing that my family and I did to yours. Grandma, I know that I can't bring Mr. Vicente's life back. But I hope that you can give me a chance to make it up to you.
I don't blame you for what happened to my son, Gael. I'm more worried about your relationship with my granddaughter, your Salvador's son. And he is Anna's mortal enemy. He will do anything to hurt her.
No, Grandma, I won't ever let that happen. I'm willing to sacrifice my life for Anna.
I hope so. I hope that you keep your word. Because I'm afraid that you might choose your family in the end. I lost a son. And I don't think I can handle it if anything bad happens to my granddaughter.
It would be better if I asked the questions.
But I thought we're going to work together.
Katrina, listen. People know you as Salvador's daughter. We'll have a hard time. But you can join in when I find something out.
Fine.
I'll start there. Happy New Year, dear.
Happy New Year, Mother.
Happy New Year!
Happy New Year!
What about you? You want to try? Huh?
Okay, that's enough for now. It's time to eat. Come right here, okay?
It's so hot.
That's enough. Come here and take a break.
Sir? Ma'am, excuse me. Sorry to disturb, but can you help me?
Just a moment.
Do you know a certain Nika Rivera?
She doesn't live here anymore. She already moved out.
Is that so? Do you know where she lives now?
Why are you asking?
Sir, I just need to ask her something very important.
Excuse me. Maybe this can help?
Wait.
No. Mister, please accept this amount for your trouble. We are not bad people at all. And I assure you, we'll only talk to Nika Rivera. You have nothing to worry about.
Can you wait here? My wife is close to Nika. So she knows. I'll call her. Wait.
Good. Thank you.
What did they say?
They're looking for Nika. Those two ladies.
What about her?
We can earn a lot if we help them.
See?
So, what's up?
I'm giving you a chance to be a father to me. I must admit, I was just carried away. I was hurt. But you're right. No matter what I do or what I say, I'm still your son. And I am still a Del Mundo.